I'm continuing my conversation with Moises Naim of the Carnegie Endowment. His new book is The End of Power. When I was reading the book, I was thinking about some of the ways that being a powerful person in the 21st century has changed. And I thought about Kim Jong-un, who runs a bankrupt, starving country, yet in a bizarre way, is an incredibly powerful man in East Asia.
Absolutely. But at the same time, you could have thought of Muammar Gaddafi, who is no longer with us, or you could have thought of all of the dictators that are no longer with us. Half of humanity today lives in under governments that are democratically elected. In a world where China, who has billions of people in its population, is an autocracy. So it is becoming harder for people like the North Korean government and the North Korean leader, to stay in power, to keep power. He can get away with it, and certainly we have other examples. But the number of autocracies has been plummeting. And look at the Arab Spring, and look at what's happening around the world with tyrants.
Two of the most admired personalities in the recent past were people that became powerful while they were almost hidden from the world. Aung San Suu Kyi and Nelson Mandela. Slightly different cases in both examples, but their power was so unconventional. The power of being under house arrest in the case of Aung San Suu Kyi ended up carrying the day. It took a long time, but she ended up being a very powerful person.
And they symbolize the forces that undermine autocracies. Both of them were symbols and were able to mobilize the energies, the hopes, the aspirations, and the political power that was against the structures of power that were dominating the South African apartheid government and the military juntas in Myanmar, in Burma. And so they symbolize the empowerment of individuals that with their example and their way of doing things were able to mobilize hundreds of formerly indifferent or apathetic or scared individuals.
So here we are talking about the end of power in 2013, at the same time as people are always talking about the new power, China. So is the rest of the 21st century and what being a superpower is going to look like going to be totally different in the case of China?
Right, except that when one thinks of China, and very often in the conversation, in the narrative about China, is this superpower. And there is a whole cottage industry of people measuring when will China will overtake the United States in terms of its GDP or the number of weapons and the quality of the weapons and so on. And that forgets the fact that China is a very poor country. Is a country that is full of contradictions, is full of social tensions. It is a country that has had a huge success in lifting out of poverty hundreds of millions of people. But at the same time, is that change, that creation of a middle class, is also creating strains and demands on the government that are in many ways undermining its ability to be that superpower that people fear.
The book is The End of Power. Moises Naim, great to talk to you.
Thank you very much, Ray.